think I want to start sort of a book for the month, or just not necessarily for the month, just as I come across really good books, just like to share it with you all. You know I did a video early in the year talking about my affirmations for the year, and so now I've gotten into my book reading, and I just want to share three books today that I am currently reading. I have not finished reading them, but so far they're really good, and so I think share the knowledge, share the wealth, share, you know, it's so important to focus on you, and this year is really about me. And you know, I tend to put everyone first, every situation first, and sometimes neglect me. So I'll start with the first book that I actually have sitting in front of me. I tend to either buy them on iBooks, I have an iPhone, or my iPad, so I don't really buy physical books anymore. But the first book, May Calls Miracles. I don't know why I just went dark when I did that. All right, May Calls Miracles. And this book is by Gabrielle Bernstein. And it is a 40-day guidebook of subtle shifts for radical change and unlimited happiness. I'm just going to read something quick that I highlighted in this book. And it's called Fear. So this one says, fear is false evidence appearing real. So this is a really good book. If you want something where each week it gives you different things that you must do, so look it up. There's like the, I'll kind of give you a brief overview, but definitely look these books up. See if they may speak to you, as I like to say. Is it for whatever you're going through, or just want a little help on? You know, look through that and just kind of decide if this is the book for you. Week one, becoming miracle minded. Week two, a new self-perception. Week three is body image. Week four is relationships. Week five is raise your self-worth, raise your net worth. Week six is working miracles. So, like I said, I'm probably on week two. Haven't gotten through the book, but if someone has read this entire book, tell me your opinion below. I'm gonna keep reading. I tend to like read different books. It's kind of hard for me to stay on one book, finish it through. So I kind of maybe read one book in the morning, read one book that I read in the evening, and another book that I just read on the weekends. All right, so the second book that I saw this lady on Oprah, it was Life Class. What was Life Class? You know the Life Class. If you don't have Oprah's channel, or if you do, definitely set the Life Class for record. They're so good. And I mean, like, it may not be what you necessarily need help in. A lot of times people say we don't need help in something, but sometimes we do. All right, so this book is, her name is, I wanted to actually get back to it, but it's called Daring Greatly, and it is by, Daring Greatly by Brené Brown. All right, and this one, How the Courage to Be Vulnerable Transforms the Way We Live, Love, Parent, and Lead. And the funny thing is, I started reading this book. I bought it shortly after the Life Class owned. And Beautiful Brown Baby Doll posted it on her Facebook today. And I'm just like, I got that book. So I was like, yeah, I really have to do a book. Just, you know, share the different books that I'm reading. So this book is really good. I will share something that I bookmarked in this book. And, oh, actually, if you look, I've bookmarked, well, you can't really see. Ah, man, I've bookmarked, let's see if I can get this clear. You can see how much bookmarking I've done. Vulnerability is like being naked on stage and hoping for applause rather than laughter. So it's like she's making you feel comfortable with being vulnerable, and it's like, we always attach being vulnerable with something bad. It's bad if you're vulnerable. It's bad if you let someone in. It's bad, you know. So keeping everyone at a safe distance and always have an exit strategy. I know, the Virgo in me, I always know how to get out of something. Like, I'm already planning my exit before I even enjoy it. So, you know, this book really is speaking to me. The other one I had one that I really wanted to read to you all. Anyway, Yeah, but anyway, so check out this book. I can't find the quote that I was just looking at for some reason, but it's really, really good. Should I give you the contents of hers? So chapter one, scarcity, looking inside a culture of never enough, debunking the vulnerability myths, understanding and combating shame, the vulnerability armor, mind the gap, disruptive engaging, wholehearted parenting, and then final thoughts. So, like I said, I haven't finished reading this one, but it is really good so far. And then the third book I actually literally just bought today. The Answer is Simple, Love Yourself, Love Your Spirit by Sonia Choquette. And I haven't gotten too far into this one, but something that I've already highlighted was, no, loving and living in the spirit within doesn't prevent you from facing life's storms. It does, however, greatly assist you in navigating the treacherous waters as painlessly and creatively as possible. And it also allows you to enjoy the journey while doing so. So basically, this one is, the answer is simple, love yourself. So, you know, especially for someone who tends to put others before them and not necessarily always putting themselves first. And it's not selfish to put yourself first. It's not selfish to live your dreams. It's not selfish to want what you want for yourself. I mean, as long as it's not something negative or whatever, you know, I'm talking about going forward with your dreams, your aspirations, your determinations, your goals, all that good stuff. So anyway, that's all. Comment if you've read any of these books. I will try to do another update as soon as I actually finish one of them. So yeah, I like reading. I just have to find the time to read. So I'm like,
oh, just TV, I'm like, let me read something decent for reality TV stuff.
Thanks for watching.